Our channel, ThePastQuest. We only post videos about history. If you find our video interesting, then subscribe our channel, like and share our videos. A 17-year-old Soviet teenager named Zinaida Portnova killed more than 100 Nazis in 1943. Zinaida Portnova, Soviet partisan. Portnova was born on 20th February 1926 in Leningrad, Soviet Union. She was the daughter of a working-class Belarusian family whose father worked in a local industrial plant. In the summer of 1941, Zinaida Portnova and her younger sister were sent to live with their grandmother in the village of Zui, near the town of Obol, Vitebsk region, Belarus. This was at the beginning of the Nazi Germany invasion of the Soviet Union, known as Operation Barbarossa. On June 22, 1941, Nazi Germany launched an invasion of the Soviet Union, codenamed Operation Barbarossa. Germany's surprise attack against the Soviet Union marked a turning point in the history of World War II. The war on the Eastern Front became the largest military conflict in the history. Most horrific atrocities, highest casualties, mass deportations, starvation, disease, and massacres. After Nazi Germany invaded the Soviet Union, under the brutal occupation, an incident with the Nazi soldiers who hit her grandmother while they were confiscating the cattle led her to hate the Germans. She witnessed the brutal treatment of her people by the Germans and was determined to fight back. During the Nazi regime, many resistance groups began to form across Europe. In 1942, Portnova joined the Belarusian resistance movement, becoming a member of the local underground Komsomol organization in Obol, Vitebsk region, named Young Avengers. The All-Union Leninist Young Communist League, usually known as Komsomol, was a political youth organization in the Soviet Union. She began by distributing Soviet propaganda leaflets in the German-occupied Belarus, including stealing German weapons for Soviet soldiers and spying on German troops' movements. After learning how to use weapons and explosives, Portnova participated in raids and sabotage operations against the Nazis. She participated in sabotage actions at a pump, local power plant, and brick factory. Hundreds of Nazi soldiers were believed to have been killed in these operations. In August 1943, Portnova carried out one of her most legendary operations, where she infiltrated a German garrison and poisoned its soldiers. In 1943, she got a job in a kitchen that served the German garrison in Obol. She poisoned the food meant for the Nazi soldiers stationed there. German troops began to fall ill from the food poisoning. At least 100 Nazis lost their lives due to poisoning. The German soldiers immediately suspected her. To prove that she had not poisoned the food and was innocent, she ate some of the food in front of them. After she did not fall ill immediately, they released her. But later she fell ill, vomited a lot, but finally recovered from the poison after drinking a lot of whey. After she did not return to work, the Germans realized she had been the culprit and began searching for her. To avoid the Germans, she became a scout for a partisan unit named after Clement Voroshilov. In a letter to her parents that month, she wrote that she is in partisan unit beating the Nazis. In January 1944, Portnova was sent back to Obol. The objective was to infiltrate the Nazi camp again and find the reason behind the failed Young Avengers sabotage mission, then find and contact the remaining members. Unfortunately, she was quickly captured. She was handed over to the Gestapo, the Nazi secret police, and interrogated. Despite being brutally tortured, she neither confessed nor gave any information. She knew her only chance of survival was to escape. There are two different versions of her escape and recapture. One is that, during Gestapo interrogation in the village of Goriani, Portnova took the pistol that was on the table and shot her Gestapo interrogator. When two German soldiers rushed in after hearing the gunshots, she also shot them. She then tried to escape the compound and ran into the forest, where she was caught near the banks of a river. Another version is that the Gestapo interrogator, in a fit of rage, threw his pistol on the table, threatening to shoot her. Partnova took the pistol and shot him. Escaping through the door, she shot a guard in the corridor, then another guard in the courtyard. After the pistol misfired, when she attempted to fire at a guard, blocking her access to the street, she was captured. After being recaptured, she was brutally tortured. She neither confessed nor gave any information. Partnova was later taken to the forest and was executed or killed during torture on 15th January 1944. On 1st July 1958, Zinaida Portnova was posthumously declared a hero of the Soviet Union. She also received the Order of Lenin.
Thank you for watching.